Friends, reading economic survey and budget document is very boring task, but when it comes to the exam, these are the two most important document which you should refer. And when you are appearing for the exams like UPSC or RBI grade B, these are the two documents which you should not leave. So in this video, I will tell you that how you can cover these two documents in just 15 minutes. And these are the some of the hacks which every top student knows, but when it comes to the average students, what they do, they just go and search here and there, what are the important things, what are these and that, and they do not find any good thing on the internet. But when it is for the toppers, they just go and use this trick to read the economic survey and budget document in just 15 or 20 minutes, and they read all the important things available in the economic survey and budget document, which will be helpful in the exam. And I'm sure that when you will discuss with any candidate who got succeeded in the exam, and then they will tell you that you should go through and read entire economic survey and entire budget document, which is practically not possible. So in this video, I will tell you this secret. Let's watch the video. First of all, let's access to the economic survey and budget document. For that, you type Indian budget or budget simply, then you search it in Google, then you will find that this indianbudget.gov.in website. Click on the union budget here, and then this government's website will appear. And in this, when you will scroll down, there are on the right hand side the budget documents related given, and then on the left, economic survey 2018-19 is given. Click on this and a new window will open. Here they will provide you the documents related to economic survey. Economic survey consists of two parts, volume 1 and volume 2. So volume 1 is generally a kind of a data related requirement, and when volume 2 comes, it is a document which helps you to get the understanding of various topics. So how you should go through it, let's say I have, these are some of the important topics in the economic survey, and this comes the economic survey part 2, sustainable development and climate change, which is a topic in grade B DR exam, price and inflation, monetary policy. I will tell you what to read in these documents. First, let's open these important documents and then we'll click. Now let's see this social infrastructure and employment and human. This is one chapter in economic survey. How you should go through these chapters in just 2-3 minutes, and you will get each and everything from these topics. I'll just scroll down these topics and see this table you should read. The global target and the Indian target. These tables are given everywhere in these chapters. Like here again, this table number 2 is given. So you don't need to go through all the economic survey documents. Just read, open some chapters. I'll tell you which chapters are important. Then in this social development chapter, just see these details are given. Then scroll it down more, and then you'll see this here, gender development they have given. Then these are the major important social schemes which are currently available, and here you will find the latest development and the important crux of these social schemes. You should go through these social schemes. They are written in such a beautiful and in a short way that you will take just 2-3 minutes to read all these things. Then scroll down and read these boxes. So let me make it large. And then recent initiatives in school education, then Samagra Shiksha and all these things. These things are important to read. They will not only help you in exam but also in interview. And if you are appearing for any kind of group discussions, you can use these terms and they will make a different kind of impression. And here again, the other schemes launched by government, their features, their objectives. And then this particular chapter is very, very important. You should never leave this chapter. If you are reading the economic survey, whether you are preparing for any kind of exam, this topic should not be left without preparation. Then you go down, 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 you will find other important topics. These documents, these bar charts, they are not important. And even if you have spare time, you can read all these things. If you have spare time, definitely they will help. And then this box number 4, like Lakshya, what is the government's view on Lakshya scheme? Then Ayushman Bharat, another important topic that you can also refer. Then Ayush. So this particular chapter is very, very important. And see there, these boxes, you should never miss these boxes. You should read these boxes. See PMGSY, ways to recycle. This particular topic is very, very helpful if you are preparing for UPSC and if you are appearing for any kind of group discussions. This will provide you a good amount of data, good amount of detail, good amount of data for discussion. And you should not forget to read these topics. And then at the end of the chapter, this is the prime important which you should go and read in each and every chapter of economic survey. Chapter at glance. It takes just 2-3 minutes. If you want to make the notes of the chapter, if you want to take the printout, you can take the printout of these chapters at glance. They will cover everything. Then we'll go to the next chapter, say fiscal development. Click on the fiscal development, then you'll see that. Let me enlarge it. Then in fiscal this development, it is not a much kind of important topic from the exams perspective. But still, there will be certain boxes and tables which you should go through, like this box 1, IPOs and OFS. What the government's view? What are the government's initiatives taken? Then defense initiative. This is again important thing that you should read. What is the government's budget allocation for the defense? Then self-reliance policy initiatives. What things government has done for the defense related matters? And keep scrolling down, go through fast, read these tables only, these boxes only. Don't read this data and all these things. This is never asked in exams, and they are not very helpful if you are, especially if you are appearing for the MCQs kind of exam. This is again chapter at glance. That is very important thing which you should read, and it will give you a very beautiful summary here. And then monetary management and financial intermediation. This topic is also important if you are preparing for RBI grade B exam and or any other financial recruitment related exam. Then you can refer this chapter also. Here they have given certain details like which are especially useful generally those candidates who are appearing for RB economic research kind of exam. They can refer this chapter. It is very helpful generally in these kind of chapters. Now except this social development chapter, they have a limited number of tables because generally tables are for the exams perspective for a common man knowledge, and the common man should know. And then in this chapter you did not find many tables, but at chapter at glance you should read. So in this way you can go through these topics like industrial development, service sector. What are the important things in service sector that you will find in the boxes and tables. And I'll suggest that read chapter at a glance in all the chapters of economic survey, then click on the key budget developments of key to budget documents. This is just a just an 8-chapter document which needs just 5-10 minutes. You can read this topic and you can take a printout of this if you want to take, and you can save it in your PC, and if you want to save, or you can directly read from here if you want to save paper. You can read from here. It is 8-page document, a very small document. And then I will tell you one other document that you should never forget to refer when you are reading budget related documents, and which is the quite very beautiful initiative of Modi government, which was not there in earlier budgets. In this year's budget, I found that this is very useful and every candidate should refer. This you will not find in any document provided by any coaching center or anywhere. Then budget highlights key features. This is the document which I was talking about. Let me just re-download this this document. And save this document wherever you want to save it in your PC. And I'll just save it. And then we can open it in our system, and which will be bigger and will be easily visible. So see this document, the key features of the budget. Here you will find what the budget envisages for, and then these reference document. This is very beautifully explained in a short, simple way, and your mind will be able to remember these things very easily. And they have make it short, yet it contains everything. So this 15-page document you should not forget to read, related to tax proposals. You can find it just five six lines. Everything, reforms, performs and transforms what government has taken, then transforming rural India, what the schemes, new schemes they have done, farmer welfare and water security related things they have given, then labor related. I'm just going through it fast, and I'll suggest that read at least once or twice this document before going for the exam. At least phase one and phase two, you should read this document just 1 or 2 days before the exams. Then key features, generally they ask what are the vision in the budget and what are the new things in the budget that you can read from here. So friends, in this way you can complete your economic survey and budget document in just 15-20 minutes. And these two things you should never forget to go through before the exam. And there are other things also, if time permits, you can read these things, but these are the minimum requirements which I have told. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. And if you liked our video, please like it in our YouTube channel. And if you are not subscriber, subscribe to our channel and give your valuable comments in the comment box. We are also available on Facebook, Twitter. You can follow us on Twitter at Prisha Academy and like us our channel on Facebook to receive the latest and updated material. You can like us on Facebook at Prisha Academy. If you have queries, suggestions, you can email us at prishaacademy@gmail.com. Thanks, friends.